This genre, also called cyber poetry as well as other names, has many definitions and, like hyperfiction, is difficult to categorize. Much poetry on the web is basically just traditional work uploaded. True hyper poetry refers to works of verse which cannot be presented without the computer. Hyper poetry includes verse with links to sub-poems or footnotes, poetry generators, poetry with movements or images. Hyperpoetry is usually highly stiff in the visual and sometimes involves parts that are read in varying orders. Holopoetry refers to three-dimensional visual art that combines words with images using holographic techniques. Some readers of HP relate hyperpoetry to concrete poetry. Prose poetry, hip-hop, performance art, and other types of hybrid arts.
Natanaga is a Philippine stanzaic form that was originally written in Tagalog. It dates back to the 16th century and has an oral tradition. The poems are not titled. Each is emotionally charged and asks a question that begs an answer.
This type of blog is personal blogs. When blogging began in the late 90s, the first type of blogger appeared was the online diary bloggers. These were people who wanted to take their daily journal online to share their experiences, feelings, and innermost thoughts with an audience. For the personal blogger, there were no rules to follow or themes to adhere. Their blogs were the open pages of their diaries, entered through a word processor and published on simple HTML pages. Personal bloggers today tend to follow the same trajectory, although they no longer have to fight the barrier to entry of setting up a website. They can use Blogger, WordPress, Tumblr, and similar networks to start a blog in less than 15 minutes and start sharing their brilliance with the world.
Chiclet is a genre of fiction concentrating on young working women in their emotion lives. One of the best chiclet example is the Bridget Jones Diary. It's a 1996 novel by Helen Fielding. Written in the form of a personal diary, the novel chronicles a year in the life of Bridget Jones, a 30-something single working woman living in London. She writes about her career, self-image, vices, family, friends, and romantic relationships. The novel revolves around 30-year-old Bridget Jones, whose life revolves around trying to lose weight and finding love. Bridget decided to change her life around for the new year by vowing to lose weight, improve her career, stop smoking, and finally find a boyfriend. Bridget is infatuated with her boss, Daniel Clever, and begins a flirtation with him. At the same time, her parents are attempting to involve her in a relationship with a recently divorced family friend, Mark Darcy. Bridget's relationship with Danielle is limited by the fact that they are not exclusive and only sometimes date. Bridget also bumps into Mark Darcy and makes a fool of herself. Bridget's parents are going through their own problems, and eventually, her mother runs away with younger man, Julio. Yet Bridget's relationship with Danielle improves and they begin to spend more time together. One day, Bridget decided to surprise him at his house and finds a naked woman, thus realizing that he is still seeing another woman. Bridget resolves that it's time to move on and think about her career instead, so she gets a job in television.
Speculative fiction. A genre of fiction that encompasses works in which the setting is other than the real world, involving supernatural, futuristic, or other imagined elements. Speculative fiction is also said to be fiction in which the author speculates upon the results of changing what's real or possible, not how a character would react to a certain event or etc. You think being speculated upon must be more elemental than character or plot. Speculative fiction is any fiction in which the laws of that world are different than ours. The setting in speculative fiction is in an alternate or parallel world. It involves the things or environment in which is currently viewed as unreal.
Flash fiction is a style of writing which involves producing very short pieces of fictional literature. This is quite different to the concept of a short story, which is usually several pages long and cannot catch up thousands of verbs. Works of flash fiction, by contrast, can comprise as little as a single page or 250 words.
Thank you.
us to share some of our original creations.
Ito'y napakasakit. Di mawala sa isip kahit na nakapikit ang puso'y sumisikip. By Chini Honkada.
In the song I listened to, I have found pieces of you. Stay by my side and don't go. These my pieces would soon go. By John May Tabasa and Sofia Nebres.
The earlier genres and the modern genres both have similarities. They express emotion, wave entertainment, and creativity.
Their difference is in the medium that they are using, the way they express it, and the way works are shared, since the early genres usually use writing by pen or hard copies as the medium of sharing their emotions and works through books or publications and stage plays. The 21st century uses a modern medium or a new way of expressing emotion, which gave way to the 21st literature genres. These genres make use of modern technology, such as gadgets and internet.
For us, it is the early genre because you can appreciate the story and poetry more because of the writing style that they use, even if it seeks for your attention more. This is because the 21st century genres is usually shallow because of the medium that is used, and it is more carefree. Most of the early genres are more filtered or checked according to its characteristics before being published. However, there are times we prefer the modern literary genres because it is more accessible, relatable, fast, and new.
It is difficult for us to say that the 21st century literature can replace those from the earlier periods. This is because both genres are unique in their own ways. They may be related yet different, coming from different eras and different mediums. The 21st literature genres are inspired from the earlier literatures. Even until now, we can appreciate the genres from them.